Y'all, this is our last series, and I'm really sad about it, but I'm really happy I'm a senior because I'm almost done. It's bittersweet. But we are in our last series of the school year, and I'm really excited about it. Before I get into it, I'd love to pray again, so if we could bow our heads. Dear Holy Father, I thank you for your presence, Jesus. I pray that you radiate through here, God, that you would speak to us in a new way, God. Awaken our spirits for you, Jesus, that we may be aligned. Alright, so we are reading from John today, and John was written by John, you guessed it. He was one of Jesus' 12 disciples, and so we're going to be reading from chapter 11. And so in John, it was his account of Jesus' life and walking with Jesus and the ministry of it. And John 11 was talking about Lazarus, and some of you may or may not know the story, but Lazarus was the brother of Mary and Martha. And he was sick. And so they sent a message out to Jesus because they knew that Jesus was a healer. And they're like, hey, like, come heal Lazarus. He's not doing too well. And so he comes, but he waits 2 days. And so he finally comes to see them. And they're like, walk up to him. And Martha's like, dude, like, why didn't you come earlier? He's passed away now. But I know that God will grant you anything you want. And Jesus responds to her and saying, I'm the resurrection. And so she says, yeah, like, yeah, I know in the end times, so, like, you're going to come back and resurrect us, so, like, to go to heaven with you. But then he responds to her in this. He says, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this? And so it talks about that, and it talks about that word. He responds to her in that, saying, I am the resurrection, not just from the dead, not just from when we go to heaven, but in life. I'm bringing you from sin to sinless, and from death to life. And then he says, I am the breath in your lungs. So apart from Jesus, we have no life. And so he goes on, and they go to the tomb. And Jesus says, open up the tomb. And she's like, he's been rotten in there for a couple days now. He stinks. He's like, open up the tomb. And he's like, no, that's gross. And Jesus said, did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? And so I want to talk about today. And so my title for the message is Three Steps to See. See the glory of God. And God can work whether you believe or you don't believe. But God can work in our lives in a new way. I don't know about y'all, but I like to grow. I like growing in my faith. And to see God's glory, to grow in that, I need to take steps to do that. And so the first part is we need to believe it. If we need to believe in God first. We need to believe in him, yes, as our Savior. But when we're walking through life, we need to believe in the truth and who he is. Because when we're aligned with him, he is in us. So when we first accept Jesus, he comes into our lives. And so the truth in who he is, love, joy, peace, patience, that's already living inside of you. It's not something you have to strive to get. It's not something you have to work really hard to get. It's already inside of you. And so we need to believe in that truth, believe in the joy inside of us, and the next step is to receive it. If someone's throwing a football at you and your arms are crossed, you think you're going to catch the football? No. We need to be open to receive all that God has for us, and the way we do that is we're open in full surrender. When we're able to receive things, you have to surrender all to God and open up every area of your life. And so when I was reading this passage, I was like, receiving it. Yes, we all want to receive something new, but I don't know if about you guys, but for me, there's a certain part of my life, I'm like, God, like, I don't want to give you that. Because I want to figure that out on my own. I want to do that by myself. And then I'm like stressed about it. I'm anxious about it. I'm like, God, like, I'm not going to give that to you. And he's like, well, if you want me to work in it, you have to give it back to me. So we need to surrender everything in our lives, believing the truth in God, and we need to receive it. God said that when Jesus died on the cross for our sins, we are forgiven. I'm going to believe that because I am not going to walk around chained to my sin anymore because I am forgiven. That is the truth. And so I'm going to receive that truth because I don't want to walk around shameful of what I did because Jesus redeemed that on the cross. And so the next step is you need to tap into it. If you want to grow in a certain area, not just in your faith, but in your job, you're going to work we want to grow in our faith, if we want to grow in anything we do, we need to tap into what it is. If I want to grow in love, I'm going to read the Bible more because it teaches me about love and about who Jesus is. If I want to grow in patience and in who he is, I'm going to learn more about him. So we need to believe in him, to believe in who he is. And then we need to receive it. Receive it with open arms. And then tap into it. Jesus has given us a free gift. It's not something we have to work for. Before Jesus died on the cross for our sins, they had to work for it. They had to work to get their salvation. We don't have to work for it. We have to believe in Jesus Christ. And so I'm going back to the verse that says, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this? He's talking about when we have resurrection from death to life. When we're walking life, he has a breath in our lungs. And so when I place my faith in Jesus, I'm not scared anymore about death because I know my fate is sealed. Did you know, like, going into heaven is like the littest party you could ever go to? It's like better than any high school party. They got angels singing like Whitney Houston up there. Like, they are killing it. And so I'm excited to go there because when we place our faith in him, our fate, where we're going, is sealed. And so we have hope in that. And so I don't want to just preach. I don't want to just speak and just me write this sermon and be like, okay, cool, just go on with my life. Because I want to apply this to my walk because I have a lot of growing to do. I don't know about you. And so my hope is that we don't just hear it and then be like, okay, cool, let's go to our next verse, but we bring it with us. We bring it with us in our classes, in our lives. Because Jesus is with you through it all. He's omnipresent. So he is always with you through everything you're